Hello once again, all you lovely people out there in the land of the Tube of Yous. It's me, That Gaming Nerd John, and we're continuing our sojourn in Citizen Sleeper. We've been assisting in a bar and making a distillery, I guess, but also ships and things and trying to get paid. But you know who isn't getting paid? That's right, it's you.
Yeah, this is true.
Ah, JC, thank you for continuing to join me in this journey, sir. All right, so, the Sycamore Seed, a Haifa farm freighter. Let's check it out. Okay, whoa! Okay, I think we only do that with a six.
Yes, because that's like an instant fail at this point.
That's crazy. I can't
even... a lot of pluses, man.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It's 12. It's like half of that. That's crazy. Okay, let's focus with our other stuff.
Yeah.
That's wild, man. Neutral, okay. Oh, I see. Okay, so there's like a soft timer on this one.
Yep.
That's two neutral outcomes so far, game. Alright. Working in the wet and the heat is a trial. You make progress, but the plants near the bulkhead look half dead. Ooh, bad. What do you think? Reroll?
Roll them bones.
I think reroll. Let's do it. Okay, a four is better.
Yeah,
I still don't feel good without... Yeah, no, we're gonna do a five. We're gonna wait until we can get a five on that one. So, and this one doesn't seem like it's actually actively ticking down. Yeah. Can we just not get a neutral outcome there?
Jesus.
That's brutal. Okay, we should probably work for a living.
Noodles?
Yeah, I think noodles. I think it's noodles o'clock. P.S. Still one of the best. Actually, hold up. What's the interaction for this one? This one's endure.
Yeah.
Hear me out. The Haifa Commune also had... Oh, those are almost done. They also had... That's engage. So that actually can get us energy and a bonus energy.
Yeah, true.
We're gonna see what happens. Boom.
Dang.
Yep. Now we just saved a dice. Don't know what we're going to use it for. Where can we work? We could work at the bar, right? Even a bad outcome is still going to give us stuff. Yeah, like a bad outcome is 10 cryo.
Yeah.
I think that's fine. A 50-50 shot. Let's go. Kaboom. Okay, we lose energy with that. Yeah, okay, fine, whatever. Dang, that's tough. Needing to have like a five to really feel good about that.
Yeah,
I guess. Okay. Next turn though, we've got some stuff.
Yep.
So, and we had what, three on that for the timer? So now we can check and see if it actually does go up. Yo, that's what I'm talking about.
No, I think that one is said specifically, any action.
Is, yeah, okay.
Yeah, so it's, we just have to work on it.
Yeah, and we got a six, so that's going to help. Because that's definitely going in there. Like, it feels bad to have to use the six on that when a five would work, but like, whatever. I'm not wanting to take chances.
Especially with that many
boom! You vent the section in a progressive sequence, allowing Bliss to rapidly rescue crops while you work. You gain more than you lose.
I mean, it still was like...
Still was a bunch.
Yeah, but...
But it sped it up. And like now, it's 50% positive, 50% neutral. So like, that's still worth it in my book. Cool game! Very cool! God bless! This is brutal. I am dying. I can't right now. I just can't. You've got to be joking me here. Amazing. We saved the city. You and Bliss are floating in the bay's airlock, waiting for it to cycle. You pick a few leaves from your clothes as you wait. They float around the chamber as if carried by a lazy wind. Clean work. Bliss bows a little. Well, thank you, sleeper. You didn't do so bad yourself. She checks her tool belt. Seems like we're getting into a good rhythm. The now familiar sequence of clunks and rattles sound out, and then the door hisses open. The moment it does, you know something has once again gone wrong. What's all this? Blitz asks a confused-looking Moritz. Beside him are a set of crates anchored to the bay floor. He has clearly just brought them in through the bay's freight lock. Moritz looks nervously between the two of you before answering. It's payment. He runs a hand along the crate. The Sycamore Sea crew just brought them over. He stops, but seeing the look on Bliss's face adds, they were very thankful. I bet they were! She clenches her fist. What the hell is inside? Moritz leans over and struggles with the catches on each side of the top crate. As he does, Bliss turns to you. Don't say it. Bliss stares into space. Don't you dare say it. Ahem. I have been waiting for the moment to give our character the proper amount of sass. And this is the moment that we can infuse it. Say what? No. She looks back at you. This isn't my fault. Moritz finally gets the catches free, and the lid floats off, drifting up into the bay. As it does, a small brown lump floats up with it. Moritz reaches out and catches it as it passes him. Is that a mushroom? Bliss finishes. A damn mushroom. Ooh.
I mean, ooh. I'm not surprised.
No, I'm not. Okay. But. Hold up. Okay.
What is this? The Mushroom Kingdom?
All right. I'm going to go with the first option. They paid us in mushrooms? Not just mushrooms. He holds out a clump of tightly packed leaves. Produce. Bliss starts laughing. God damn, I've a commune. Should have known they didn't have a chit to rub between them. She knocks a small brown mushroom across the bay. Stop, Bliss. Moritz grabs her hand. These are good, fresh. We can sell them. To who, Moritz? Are we running a grocer's now? We need cryo, otherwise this whole bay will be shut down. We can't pay for parts with leafy greens. She waggles them in Moritz's face. Ooh. I can use them. Bliss raises an eyebrow. What, four whole crates? Even you can't be that hungry. You can take a few, but the rest will sell. She smiles to herself. Or, at least Moritz will sell them, if he is so eager. Moritz closes up the crates and starts moving them. It isn't that bad, Bliss. It's a step in the right direction. He glances at you, looking for backup. It's not great. Not great, Bliss repeats. Well, that's a change from absolutely dire, at least. She waves Moritz away. You have my blessing. Sell away. She kicks away towards the new patched-together terminal. Until then, I'll be working on how to keep this place open. Moritz goes back to moving the crates. You'd better be on your way, too. You grab a handful of mushrooms on your way out. No use letting them go to waste. What do we get? Literally mushrooms. Yep. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's the good stuff.
I was hoping we would get the good mushrooms, you know, just putting it out there. Looks like, what is that, two or four? Four. Okay. Wait, what? Damn it. Third time lucky. Bliss is taking another shot at landing a contract. After the run you've had, this seems like a last chance. I fucking love it. Oh, man. Whoo! Mushrooms. They paid us in mushrooms. Yeah, I can feel that. Alright, so we're gonna need to dump some money. It pains me. That's almost back. We'll go with Emphas. Like, 12 credits is cheaper than anywhere else.
Yeah.
And, like, that is gonna recover, yeah, 3. Cool. Alright. Let's check on the Greenway, because I might have us just chill there. Oh! Riko has something in her hands when you enter the lab. It looks like a knotted twist of woody stems, a ring about the circumference of a human head, consisting of a single stalk at one end and a branched, woven network at the other. As you approach, she holds it up, and in the lights of the lab, it looks like a crown. Riko finishes your thought. She smiles and shakes her head in disbelief. Is that what grew? It is. I came to the plant this morning, and this loop was all that was there. She points to a lump on the edge of the ring. The seed grew right back into itself, twisting up out of the soil. That being you encountered in the cloud, as you call it, was it wearing one of these? She eyes you suspiciously, still unsure if she is somehow embroiled in an overlong prank. It doesn't work like that. She sighs. Perhaps wearing was the wrong word. She places the object on the bench and shuffles to her analysis terminal, her face lit by its amber light in the dim corner of the lab. Well, it isn't exactly a plant anyway. Not from what I can tell. She gives you a serious look. No leaves, no chloroplasts, just a series of filaments encased in cellulose walls. Filaments? Question mark? See, that's why I like you, Sleeper. You're so good at spotting the unusual details. She beckons you over. Look at this. You see a cross-section scan of the crown, its layers of plant-like structure on full view until you reach the center. There, instead of xylem and phloem, for transporting nutrients, something branched and woven glints. Are those wires? She laughs. I'm not sure whether to say yes or no here. These are not wires like those in an electrical system. No, but they are filaments of a conductive material. So, yes? She leans closer to the screen. But you see those branches? They remind me of dendrites, of neurons. She rubs her eyes, which is frankly ridiculous. You look back at the crown on the table as Riko fusses over the scans, and you suddenly realize what it reminds you of. You remember signing the forms, the walk to the sleeper tanks, the cold metal floor. Then you remember the crown they fitted you with, the branching structures of wires and pads. No, not a crown. They called it an interface. The tool of your emulation, your transference from neurons to electrons. An interface. That is your gift from the gardener. You turn back to Riko. I'm in. No, it's an interface. Riko looks at you puzzled. Something clicks in her mind. Perhaps something she heard from the sleeper she had helped all those cycles ago. She starts talking, partly to you, partly to herself. If the club heads were made for you, then this too could be made for you, for your frame. She shuffles over quickly to the interface, a word that is stuck to this strange branched object quickly in your mind. You are right. That entity, it is the entity I have been looking for. She shuffles quickly to the crown. They are the entity which is controlling the Greenway, which has been maintaining it, supporting it, and has been guiding it for all these decades. She stops to catch her breath. They want to talk with you. Riko leads you to a seat. I will be here, Sleeper, if something happens, if you wish me to remove the crown, the interface, just squeeze. She grips your hand tightly. You meet her eyes, clouded with age, but bright with the thrill of new discoveries. Then she places the interface on your head, and everything blinks out. The cloud in the data ghost of the eye. Back into the river. Back into the dark flow, but something is different now. You're no longer pushed, no longer blocked and buffeted by the swarm, by the storm. Instead, it flows around you. You move, and it parts, letting you pass. Something else resists, but it gives easily enough. You look back and see your body. You have left it behind. Somewhere, Rico's voice is talking to you, asking you questions. It is excited, eager, desperate to know what lies on the other side, what the entity has to say to you. You realize how long she has waited for this moment, for the moment of meeting between the inhabitants of the Greenway and its protector, and yet she is still on the outside. You shake off the sadness. You will be her eyes. Then you see the figure, Gardner, out in the storm, planting. Gardner, ingrown farm administrator! It takes less than a moment to reach them. You have never felt so free. This is how Navigator must have felt, released from their prison. This, you think, is what it feels like to be in the place you were built to inhabit. Gardner does not turn at your approach. They go on planting, but their voice whispers in the waters like a sharply rising current. You grew the gift. Their speech hisses around you. Good. I am glad. Well, we know he's Gardner, so, like, I mean, we kind of know who he... No, I'm kidding. I feel like that is more in line with, like, our inquisitive nature.
Yeah.
Yeah. Who are you? Gardner is a good name. You choose it well. I will grow into it. How does it feel to be free of your seed? They stoop to plant again. Questioning, my seed? That in which you are contained, from which you will grow. There was some disagreement, continues Gardner, as if you were picking up on a long-held conversation with the others. They felt you were a danger, but they are always cautious, especially the fungi. They, like old loam, known knowns, wide and stable networks. The fungi were cautious? Mostly yes, although there are many among their number who favor short growth cycles, thick nutrient veins, and sudden shifts. He gestures out into the storm, and though you cannot see them, you feel presences all around, sensing this audience with great interest. After all, they understood that it was I who made them their crowns, and without them, they would not have joined the chorus. So they see it is only fair that you get your chance to join too. Join? Yes. Become part of this. Gardner stoops again. We are millions, and we grow. I hope you understand. I am unused to speaking to your kind. It has been many cycles since my last conversation. I think it was with Chief Executive Trellick himself. You look around and you see it. Every growing thing, every non-human being in the Greenway is here. They are networked, connected, branched, and linked by this strange being, this artifact of the old station. The impossible dream of a senile farm administration AI, a living network. You could dissolve here, you realize, free of that decaying body. You wouldn't need to be a person, why would you, among all these other minds? You turn away from Gardner for a moment and look back at your body. A tiny hairline thread connects it to you. You hear Rico's voice again, still asking, still checking in. Are you okay, Sleeper? What are they saying, Sleeper? Are you still there, Sleeper? Something in you sighs, a long sigh. A sigh that speaks of an exhaustion beyond tiredness. An exhaustion rooted deep inside you. It stems from the effort of answering questions, of answering problems, of getting up and breathing each cycle. But something else resists the sigh. A yearning, a sense of distance, a desire to squeeze that hand that holds you for its warmth, its blood, its complexity. To make a gesture that says, I'm still here. I'm still alive. I'm with you. The two ideas spin within you, making you nauseous. If you break that thread, you will be free. Free to dissolve here, to grow strange and beautiful among a million others. If you follow it, if you squeeze Rico's hand, you will wake up, back in that dying body, with all the pain and warmth that entails. Now is the moment to choose.
This is an ending.
I think so. I think we follow the thread back.
Yeah.
Your eyes track the thread across the whirling dark back to your body. This choice, you realize, will not be considered again. Ooh, will not be presented again. Yeah, it sounds like an ending. No, we'll follow it back. You don't look back at Gardner. You don't dare risk it. Instead, you follow the thread, delicately, carefully, like a driver following their lifeline back to the surface. Diver, close enough. The river whirls around you, but it doesn't pull. It isn't jealous. Neither does it understand. It is, after all, just a river. It isn't a person, a flesh and blood person, with wants, with desires, with the capacity for love and hate. It doesn't understand you, and you don't understand it. So you don't focus on it. You don't think about it. On what feels like such a long journey back through the dark, you set your mind on eyes instead. On hands. Things you can focus on. Hold on to. And then, after an age of crossing, you are there, settling back into the chair, into a body in a chair, and the overwhelming sensations that come with being a living thing with a rich and detailed sensorium. For a moment, you feel like you have made a terrible mistake. Who would choose this weight, this anxiety, this deep well at the center of existence? But then you feel it, Rico's hand, gripped hard around yours, trembling a little, sweating a little. Rico's hand with its brittle bones and crumpled skin. Rico's hand. And in that moment, you understand why you made this choice. And then you squeeze Rico's hand, and you wake up.
Oh.
Whoa!
The ending either way.
Wild! I did not expect that to be an ending.
I did.
What? Whoa! Okay, well, first of all, we did it. Congratulations to us.
Yeah.
I mean, in all fairness, let's be real here. We had reached a point where there was very little left for us to pursue.
Yeah.
We got rid of the tracker. They weren't going to go and find us. We got rid of all the evidence related to the tracker. Like, nobody knows that we exist here.
Yeah.
That's kind of neat. That's kind of neat that it just, like, boom, was there. Now, grant you, I would have preferred a warning, like, hey, picking this is going to end the game.
Yeah.
Oh, that's wild. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. And it sends us back. Interesting.
Okay, so it's not done.
So we're not done? Oh, okay, this is kind of neat. All right. Sleeper? Rico's voice comes wavering through the dark. Are you still with me? You sit up. The lab, a bright green glare that fades as you gather yourself.
Oh, thank God we still have the selection.
You're not wrong! Thank goodness for that. I'm here. Rico smiles. Good. She squeezes your hand. I thought you'd left me for a moment. What? She pauses. Who? She smiles. Tell me about it. Tell me everything. Oh, we gotta tell her the truth. Are you kidding?
Oh, yeah.
I can't lie to Rico. She's like my mom. You tell Rico everything. You tell her about the gardener, that strange farm administrator AI that has grown to be so much more. About the chorus, that impossible configuration of network plants. And finally, about the choice the gardener offered you. She listens attentively, but her responses are hard to read, and you wonder if she might have made a different decision had she been in your place. Thank you, Sleeper, for telling me. I know it isn't easy to say such things. People so often do not wish to hear strange truths. She looks away. And thank you for returning to me, though I know you had your own reasons. She squeezes your hand reassuringly. Something passes between you then, a kind of shared sadness for the impossible choice. The choice to escape your body, or to stay and suffer it. Her smile is warm and generous, and whatever the wisdom of your choice, you're glad to feel welcome in this moment, in this place. Then suddenly, she stands and walks a little away, as if trying to escape an unpleasant thought. You worry that she knows all too well what it takes to make a choice like you did. Rico sighs. So, Sleeper, do you plan to stay in the commune with us? I'm going to say for a while.
Yeah.
I'm glad to hear it. Rico crosses back over to you and takes one of your hands in both of hers. Haifa needs new blood if it wants to survive, and she squeezes. You are a good friend. Stay silent. No. No, I can't be mean. The feeling is mutual. Well, don't let me keep you. Rico waves you away and limps back to her terminal. As she does, you notice the crown in her hand, and she places it on the bench with great care. You can't help but feel a little curious about what she intends to do with it. Then you are out, breathing the air of the greenway, fresh as a spring morning. The dappled light makes a patchwork of the greening landscape, and you walk into it, sensing the movements of the gardener's chorus all around you. And you are glad to be here, in this strange and beautiful place, a little longer. We're still alive. So we can, like, still play the game.
Yeah. go back up to that area. Okay.
Good news. We've still got the labs, my guy. We can still synthesize. I think that is one of those, like, you have finished this storyline. Yeah. So, like, the AI storyline tying in with Rico.
Yeah.
I think that has completed now. We've still got a turn left on the aviary. So it doesn't seem like that's, like, a game end to me. I still feel like there's more to discover. Because we gotta get that ship. I need that ship. Okay. Alright, well, first of all, we don't got any more dice. So we gotta call it.
And honestly, I think this is also a good time to call it.
You are not wrong. Wow! What? Okay, first of all, I did not anticipate that would be the end of that tale.
Yeah.
Whoa. That was some heavy stuff there. That was some deep philosophical thoughts there that they were trying to evoke. Some strong emotions there. Which is one of the things I really like about this game is that it has that ability to ask those questions to the player and really have you make that choice. And it seems like either way it was going to, like, either be like a game end, or like a thanks for making this choice, you're still back in it kind of thing. Fascinating. Very interesting. I did not anticipate that being how that was going to play out. Which I'll be honest, this game has thrown a lot of surprises at us. I'm digging it. But you know, JC, people don't have to be surprised about something. And that's when the next video is going to come out, because they could like and subscribe as well as hit that bell notification so that they are informed very simply about when more content will be coming out for this series and many others. So, with that in mind, thanks so much for watching. Hope you all are enjoying. And as always, until next time, take it easy.
Later, everyone.